Another day, another truck full of Amazon deliveries. This is like not a lot of stuff. This is actually a pretty easy day, which means I'm probably gonna be doing some rescues, which means I'm probably gonna have a really long day again. Good. Yeah, I have definitely burnt like the top of my head. You see that? It's like a darker color. That's great. That's what having a massive freaking forehead will do. Like, just the top part of it is gonna get sun, and it looks weird. So I'm at the very least nowhere near as sleepy today as I was yesterday. I'm still pretty damn tired, I gotta tell you that much. I'm still pretty damn tired, but I showered last night. In fact, I think I told you on the vlog, I got home, took a shower, and then pretty much went straight to bed. I knocked out pretty easily, and then I woke up at like 3 because I hadn't set an alarm. I guess I somehow subconsciously knew that I hadn't set an alarm. So I woke up and, set that. And then this morning I stayed in bed until 9 because I could. And also I've learned, while I was told that you can clock in as early as 10:30, you're not supposed to, and they've been stopping people from doing it recently. They've been like, because we clock in on basically on an iPad, so they've stopped putting the iPad out until like exactly 10:45. I didn't know if my schedule started at 10:30 or 10:45. I guess that officially confirms it's 10:45. So because of that, because I knew that I wouldn't be able to clock in until 10:45. I didn't bother leaving the house until a little bit later, which meant that I could stay in and stay in bed until 9. So ultimately, just a better morning overall. I also washed my clothes this morning. God, it feels weird having my hair down. I never have it down, but it's certainly a nice feeling. I can't keep it down because it's gonna get in my way while working, but whew. So long now. But yeah, I got a decently big truck or van today. I'm at my first stop, by the way. That's why I'm just like chatting with you guys before I actually fully start. I'm at my first stop. I've realized that this van is the one that I had the other day that doesn't have a step out of it. So I'm gonna have to like jump out of the van over and over again today, and it's gonna kill my legs that are already hurting. I forgot to apply baby powder again, so I'm probably gonna chafe again. But at the very least, I only have 9 bags and 9 overflow, which is not a lot. That's a really small amount, and it's like 103 stops. So, and I think they're all decently close together, and it doesn't look like any of them are like down garbage, like country road type things, but I guess we'll find out. Also, we had a Splatoon 3 direct this morning. I'll probably catch up about that tonight. I'll just kind of give you my brief thoughts. But I'm excited for that game. Comes out September 9th, I think. Is it? Yeah, September 9th. And I've got it pre-ordered. I'm really excited to play it. And there's going to be like a global, basically a global test fire on the 28th of this month. And I believe I'm off work that day. So I'm very excited. It is 5:45 and I just got done with my route. It admittedly took me a little bit longer than it probably should have, or than I feel like I could have done. But I've been moving pretty slow today, I'm not gonna lie. I am very tired because I'm on my 5th day in a row. I'm sweating my ass off. I'm chafing up a storm. So I still got it done though. You know, all I've got left there is bags. And I've been told, I called dispatch, and I was honest. I was like, what are the odds of me not rescuing someone today? Because I'm exhausted. And they just said, that is totally fine. You've done a ton of rescues this week anyway. But they do want me to head to a car wash, because apparently like once a week or once every couple of weeks, they have people who wash the interior of the vans, and I guess probably the exterior as well. But they won't be there till 6:30. It's about 45 minutes from now, but I'm about 30 minutes from the car wash. So I'm just gonna head over there, chill for a bit. Dude even said like, just get paid for 45 minutes. Like. So I'm gonna get that done, go gas up, and head home. So I imagine that, you know, I'm still gonna be getting home probably around like 8, I would say, maybe. Something like that. Just before, between 7:30 and 8, I would estimate. But that's still not that bad. And then I have the next 3 days off. I'm so happy about that.
It is 8:06 and I just got back in my car. I think I had estimated getting home between 7:30 and 8, but what happened was I got to the car wash and sat there for an hour as more and more Amazon drivers piled in, just for the cleaning guys to not show up. So our dispatch texted us like, yeah, just come back, they're not showing up. So that took a bit. It's now 8:06. I'll be home like close to 9, but either way, I'm done. I haven't felt like I've earned a break, like worked to earn a break in a while. This week I do. I just did 5 days straight, between 8 and 10 hours every single day, driving 45 minutes to and from work every day, while also trying to do a bunch of other stuff. Yeah, I think I've earned this 3 days off. I feel good about it. I don't feel good about the dark red blobs or whatever the color that is on my forehead.
All right, so it's late and I'm super duper tired and worn out and just exhausted in every way possible. So I will catch you in the morning for a recap of the Splatoon Direct.
Alrighty, it is, of course, the next day now. It's also 11 p.m., so I gotta make this kind of quick. Let's talk about this Direct, just real fast. I'm just gonna kind of skim through, kind of just briefly touch on the things that I personally really like about it. They kind of just showed off a bunch of, like, stuff that we kind of already know from the first two games. They were like, oh, hey, here's how you play the game. Here's the different modes of the game. Here's some of the new stages and some of the weapons and stuff that are coming back. But there's just a couple of main things that I wanted to touch on here. So for one, some of these special weapons are really, really cool looking. This one right here, I think, was... Yeah, the Tacticooler. It's like a support weapon type thing where you pick up drinks to give you and your team buffs, and there's like four of them. So your entire team gets to use it. That's really cool. And then skipping ahead a little bit, this thing is like an echolocator and then blows people up, which is cool. Thought that was really cool. I don't know. It looks cool. They got some new weapons, some new sub-weapons, some new everything. It's cool. Sheldon licenses are a new way for you to pay for weapons. You can pay a little bit more to get them ahead of time, which is really cool. They went on a whole thing about the different shops and the different gear you can buy, all that stuff. Merch has grown up since the first game. He was like the little tiny dude from the first game. And now he's like a British teenager. You can save your gear combinations as fits so that you can like switch off to him. There's just a bunch of cool quality of life stuff coming to Splatoon 3. And I think that is incredible. But I'm not going to go on and talk about like all of those little things. There's some really neat stuff in here. Like you've got your own locker you can customize somewhere in here. I just skimmed over it. There's like a card game. Just tons of stuff. I'll leave this linked below so you can watch the whole thing. My favorite parts of this were, one, Salmon Run. I think Salmon Run is the best thing that Splatoon 2 added. I think it's absolutely incredible. Look at these bosses. Look at this artwork, for that matter. I really love this. Are they all there? Is that all of the previous bosses, including the new ones as well? I believe it is. I think that this is the Maws right here. Is this the Maws? I think this is the Maws. Fly Fish up here, of course. Scrapper, Stingray, all those things. But I think they showed off a couple of the new ones. Yeah, Slammin' Lid. What the heck is this thing? Right, it creates a barrier. I gotta rewatch this. I kind of skimmed through it myself before going to work today, but... It's neat! Big dude wearing a tank top. Big shot. Actually, I must have missed this. Oh. Interesting. Oh, and they like... Oh, it's lagging. Hang on. And then Big Boy. So as expected, Big Boy... Oh. Yeah, I've definitely got a lower or slower internet connection right now. King Salmonid. Let me pause because this person is very loud. It's a, like a mega boss. Let me turn this down a little bit. Mega boss that appears on like certain waves. And I'm assuming there's going to be other ones, too. It doesn't look like this is the only one. which is incredible. And you can shoot eggs at it to do damage. So I guess you still have to get eggs, maybe? Or do you? No, it says it's an extra wave up here. So my internet's really struggling right now, but yeah, that's neat. New amiibo, which of course I'm very happy about. I don't know why my internet has slowed right down right now, but look at this. I can't even load this. Octoling in blue, Inkling in yellow, and then Small Fry. I love Small Fry. I want him. I want him in my collection right now, even though his amiibo is mostly just ink. And then they introduced the new idols for this game right here. You know, we have Callie and Marie, we have Pearl and Marina. Now, if it would show their names, we have Shiver, Fry, and Big Man. I love Big Man. And given we got amiibo for the other idols, I am assuming we're going to get them for these guys eventually. And I, for one, cannot wait for my Big Man amiibo. Anyway, there was a few other things like the Splatfest World Premiere. This is essentially the Splatoon 3 demo. It's going to be on August 27th, which, quite conveniently, I have off work. So I'm going to actually be able to partake in this, which I'm very glad about. And I'll probably try and record a video of it. And also, I just want to mention that the actual, like, renders of the characters in Splatoon 3, their quality has shot through the roof from Splatoon 2. They look incredible. Incredible. Get it? Haha. So there was that, and then there was also a tournament announced happening at PAX West, which, of course, I'm not going to be able to go to, but that's a thing. All right, that's pretty much everything I wanted to touch on. I talked for a lot longer than anticipated, and this vlog's probably overrunning at this point. I just wanted to kind of give you a brief overview of a couple of things that I really enjoyed out of this. Most notably, the amiibo, Big Man, the additions to Salmon Run, and some of the new weapons and stuff. Like that bow looks cool as hell, and I really cannot wait to play this game. It comes out in less than a month. It comes out on September 9th, so super duper excited for Splatoon 3. And because this vlog won't be out for a while, I guess I'll announce this. Once I'm done with Sonic Generations 3DS, I'm doing Splatoon 2. So super excited to be doing that as well. Anyways, that's going to be it for today. So thank you all for watching. Stay tuned for tomorrow, and I'll see you guys then.